I'm taking off these Ray-Bans. Whatever floats your boat, whatever pops your top, we got time to kill.
Well, thanks, Dave, very much. That was kind of you. Good morning, everyone. You just don't know how happy I am to be with all of you this morning. Thanks again to our board of directors and the ASA staff who work so hard for you every day to support you and the needs of the sport fishing industry. In my prep for this morning's talk, it became very apparent that it's hard to have a conversation without someone bringing up forward-facing sonar. I see some of you cringing. I see others drooling. No matter what, it's here to stay. And it got me to thinking about sonar as a metaphor for how we look at the past, the present, and the future. So if we look behind the boat, we're told back in 2023 that there would be a recession. Well, that didn't happen. However, when I asked dozens of you how you did last year, a large majority of them told me that business was off between about 5 and 15%. That's not good. But keep in mind, that was compared to 2022, which was still a solid year for many. And while closeouts and deep discounts helped close the gap the end of the year, it couldn't quite get you back to where you were in 2022, and nowhere close to where your record sales were in 20 and 21. Another comparison comes from our annual report on tackle sales produced by Southwick Associates. If you tally on a single graph the total sales from years 2017 to 2024, you can see the COVID bump. But if you remove 20, 21, and 22, when the lines come together, now you see just a slight increase since 2019. 200 independent retailers told us in our annual retail survey, businesses were relatively flat in 2023 as they cleared out leftover inventory. Regionally, in the Northeast and Midwest, retailers struggled and sales were down several percentage points, while those in the South and the West actually showed some growth. We asked them, what factors affected changes in sales? The number one positive impact, by far, was having new product in their stores. At the same time, inflation had the biggest negative impact on sales. You can read the entire report and find out so much more interesting data at asafishing.org. The best news about 2023 is there are more anglers than ever before. As Dave mentioned, 57.7 million people went fishing last year. And when you compare the data that RBFF study from this year with their report from 10 years ago, we will see an increase of almost 12 million anglers. That's more than a 25% increase over those 10 years. And if we look at the number of women anglers from then till now, we see an increase of 35%, while Hispanic anglers are up a whopping 77%. Amazing numbers. Now we need to be sure to retain them. Okay, let's now adjust our view to the side scan sonar. Still a view off the back of the boat, but it gives us a little bit more of ability to see from either side of the year. So far in 2024, we have been somewhat disappointed that the year has not quite met our expectations. I've heard from dozens of you that 2024 is better than last year, but not quite as good as expected, or it's good, not great. Round figures tell us that manufacturers are flat to maybe up 10% in 2020 from 23, most under 5%. The retailers seem to be placing maybe more orders, but they're smaller orders, as they would like to receive the product just in time for the season, rather than have it sit on the shelves. Of course, while sales have generally ticked up, so have expenses. Labor, distribution, materials, electricity, rent, inflation, you get the idea. Profits might be up. But, or excuse me, obviously sales up, but profits down. Circana, the leading research company for POS data, was kind enough again to share a few of their top line POS numbers from the major retailers, which make up more than 50% of the overall tackle sales across the nation. Circana's data shows us that fishing equipment revenue represents more than $1.7 billion in sales from January through May of this year. This is how the pie is sliced across those different categories. Now, if we compare January through May of 2024 to January of May of 2023, we see fishing equipment sales have actually increased by about 4%, thanks to a strong Memorial Day. That reminds us of what I mentioned before. Not bad, better than last year, but not quite as good as expected. During that same period, rods, reels, and were actually up about 6%, while lines, lures, and terminal tackle were up about 5%. Even better, just the month of May, numbers showed an increase of about 7% overall. That's a good sign. But interest rates continue to limit manufacturers and retailers from making big investments, and inflation negatively impacts the discretionary spend by consumers on fishing tackle. Weather always seems to be a factor anymore. Last winter, there was little to no ice up north, big winds in the south and the east all winter and spring, and some folks are wondering when that rain is gonna stop. Geez, add your girlfriend just left you on a couple of shots of whiskey and you've got Chris Stapleton's next big hit. Okay, we can't talk about the state of the industry without talking about government overreach and the impact that government's decisions are having on fishing. I want to start by saying we, the US of A, have the best fisheries policy in the world, and we are the envy of other countries. With that said, we've got issues. You've been hearing for almost 2 years about that NOAA wants to slow down 35-foot and larger boats to 10 knots from November to May along the East Coast to protect the right whales. Obviously, that would devastate the boating industry as well as many of your businesses and communities along the East Coast. We, along with many of our partners like the NMMA, have provided NOAA with more than enough data as well as great alternatives through technology, plus the support of Congress to have them delay their decisions for now. The final rule could come out sometime this year, although the election in November may have a factor into this decision. It will all be up to the courts, Congress, or the next administration to fix this disastrous rule. And what about Red Snapper? In another example of government overreach, the National Marine Fisheries Service decided that Red Snapper season in the South Atlantic was last Friday, July 12th. One day. That's not a season. That's a slap in the face. Can you all imagine if the government told us that we could only fish for bass for one day this year? That's right, because the National Marine Fisheries Service has been unable to come up with better methods to count fish, they have underestimated the number of sizable snapper once again in the Southeast, and anglers suffer. It makes no sense. And unfortunately, there are plenty of other examples like West Coast rockfish, Pacific salmon, stripers in the Northeast, North Carolina flounder, Florida grouper, and even the golden tilefish need attention. So where is ASA in all this, besides trying to make sense of it all for you? Well, like forward-facing sonar, we are continually scanning the landscape for issues that impact you and determine the best course of action to help you make more intelligent decisions for your businesses. You've heard me say it before. ASA's mission is to look out for the interests of the sport fishing industry and the entire recreational fishing community. Our government affairs team is addressing these fish issues and so much more, even battling groups that are trying to ban lead fishing tackle. Mike Leonard is doing a balancing act, working with the Biden administration and his agencies, policymakers from the House and Senate, state agencies and other nonprofits, as well as our industry to help shape a positive outcome. But with issues this big, we can't do it alone. Your help is critical, and we make it easy for you to get involved. With our advocacy arm, Keep America Fishing, we do most of the work for you. KAF raises awareness on the issues, educates you on the facts, and provides the tools to take action. Your organization has substantially broader reach to consumers than we do, and when you share your message, we go from reaching 1 million anglers to reaching 10 million anglers. I challenge you to help us get the message out. Be sure to sign up for Keep America Fishing emails so you can get our alerts and act on them. And please spread the word to your friends, family, colleagues, and customers. Now let's click over to our education section of the website where you'll find so much more great information, including toolkits on sustainability, PFAS, the excise tax guide, and a ton of valuable research. And today, I am excited to announce our new ASA Education Hub. We've contracted with the Marine Retailers Association of the Americas to offer ASA members dozens and dozens of webinars and tools to navigate through today's business climate and learn how to be more successful in the future. It's a members-only platform, so ASA members can enjoy this great benefit for free. If your company's not a member, come see me or any of the ASA staff. This is a big step for the association to go beyond advocacy and our trade show and provide more educational tools at your fingertips. So let's finally take a look at the future. Excuse me. There are many reasons to believe the future is bright for our industry. For example, the S&P has grown another 25% over the last 12 months. The economy is quite strong. There are more anglers than ever before. Inventories are at manageable levels. New products are moving the needle. And the Fed just might actually cut interest rates this fall. If we look at 2025 and beyond, the Supreme Court rulings that have just happened over the last few weeks could impact how federal fisheries manage our fisheries and how we can fight back. There'll be more to come on that. Also, while I'm not a weatherman, you can probably expect that we'll probably have limited ice up north next winter. And if there is ice, please allow the retailers up there to sell the product you sold in the last 2 years. It's also probably going to be windy on the East Coast and Southeast. There'll be droughts out west, and we're going to have rain in the Midwest. Would that forecast surprise anyone? There will also be a president, there will be an administration and a Congress, there will be unrest in the Middle East, there will be issues with China, and there will probably not be much relief on inflation and interest rates. Sorry to tell you about that. But the one thing you can count on is the ASA. We will always have your back. We're going to take the high road and always keep the door open to fight another day. We will be your advocate. We will offer you engagement with our community, and we will educate you on how to be successful today and in the future. You can count on us.